Hi everyone, welcome. In my previous video, I have shown you basic authentication using username and password, and also I have shown you bearer authentication by passing the token number. So in this video, I am going to show you how we can authenticate API by passing the API key. So for that, I am going to use an API, that is Google Maps Places API. So to access this API, we need to have API key, which we need to generate by using Google account. So first of all, let's see how we can generate API key for this particular Google Maps API. And also we need to understand what's the functionality of this particular Google Maps Places API. So we'll see some documentation. And after that, I will show you how we can create API key and then how we can use that API key in your script. So first of all, let me just go to Google Maps Places API documentation. So let me just give you one URL. I'll provide this URL in the description. So once you open this URL, and here in this link, it's provided, Google Maps is provided a lot of APIs which is supported currently. So they have divided APIs into multiple parts like Maps APIs, Routes, and Places APIs. So the different APIs are provided here. So to access all of them, we need to generate API key. Okay. So here under Places, I can see one API called Places API. Now I'm going to use this Places API. I'm going to access this Places API by generating API key. So let me just click on this link and it will give you detailed documentation about this particular Places API. So here it is clearly saying like the Places API is a service that returns information about places using HTTP request. So places are defined within this API as establishments, geographic locations are prominent points to prominent points of interest. So it is also given some other information. So we'll go through this in detail. Now, if we just go and click on the get API key. So to access any of these Google Maps API, we need to generate a API key. All right. So here we need to follow certain steps actually. So once you click on the get API key. So here you can see the actual steps they have provided to generate your API key. So these are the steps we need to follow. But before going to follow these steps, we need to first create a project. Let me write the notes in the description. So let me open the notepad. So here, this is a link just now I have shown you as a documentation. So now I'm going to show you how we can generate the key. So first of all, before generating the key here, I have just clicked on the get key. They have given some steps here. Okay, we need to follow the same steps. So before that, we need to have a new project. We need to create a new project in the Google Developer Console. So this is the first step they are saying here. Visit the Google Cloud Platform Console. And in this Google Cloud Platform Console, we can create our new project. And then we can generate API key for on that particular project. And also we need to enable that API key. So there are three steps we need to follow. So first we need to create a new project in the Google Developer Console, and we can open the Google Developer Console by using Google Cloud Platform Console. And inside this, we need to create a new project. We need to generate API key, and also we can enable the API key. So these three steps we can perform inside the Google Cloud Platform Console. Now, after doing these steps, we can access that API by using this URL. So this is basically a get request we can send. And here this is a URL, and we can pass multiple parameters like location, radius, types, name, and key. All right. Now we'll see step by step. So first of all, let me just go to Google Cloud Platform Console, open another tab. So in this, currently I already created a few projects, and I will also show you how to create a new project. So once you open this, right? So here, now I have opened this. So if I just click on this drop-down menu, it will show you what are all project which is already created. Okay. Now I'm going to create my new project. So here, how to create a new project, we need to click on the new project. So click on the new project. And here I'm giving some project name. I'll say my project name is testing123. And this project is not there earlier. So I'm just creating a new project called testing123. So I'm also noting down here, my project name is testing123. So once you created here, click on the create. Now it is creating a new project here. Now we can see create project testing123 is creating now. It takes a few seconds of time. And once you created this particular project, then we can generate API key for that particular project. So once it is created a testing123 project, then what I should do is from this drop down at the top, we have to select our project in this list. So this is a testing 1, 2, 3. This is a new project just now we created. Now select that project. Click on the project. It will automatically selected in the drop down. All right. So once you selected this, now just go to this navigation menu. And now we need to generate API key for this particular project. So how we can generate API key for this project? So we need to go to APIs and services. And inside the APIs and services, you need to go to credentials part. So click on the credentials and make sure your project is selected here. Okay. So once you select the credentials, and here it will give you one more menu. And here we need to select create credentials. And here we need to select API key. So once you created this API key, now it will give you one more pop-up window. So here API key is created. So this API key we are going to use in our script. Let me make down here. So this is our API key we have just created on this particular project. Now the third step is we need to enable the places API on this particular project. So that thing we have to do. So first close this. Now once you created your API key, now go to the dashboard. Right, once you go to the dashboard, so here we already selected our project. So here there is an option called enable APIs and services. So whatever APIs we want to access in this project, we should enable them. So then click on enable APIs and services. And what are all APIs you want to enable, you can just select those APIs. So currently I'm going to enable Google Places API. So you can see here there are multiple APIs are there. I'm going to enable Places API. Now I'm clicking on this Places API. Now it is Places API description is given and here API is enabled. Okay, so if you don't get this link, so you need to sometimes you will get enable button. So once you click on the enable button, your API will be enabled, right? So then go back again. So we have done all the setup. So we have created a new project in the Google Developer Console and we have also generated API key and also we have enabled API for this particular project. Now we also have a request URL. So in the request URL, we need to pass location, radius, types, like food or restaurant or theaters, whatever you want to search for, and the name of the food or name of the restaurant or name of the movie theater. You can also specify the name and also key you have to pass here. And then it will give you proper information. So now let's send this request in our Robot Framework script. So we need to also pass API key as a parameter. So now we have done the setup, everything is ready. Then go to PyCharm. So under test cases, I'm going to create new file, new test, that's TC11 underscore. And I'll say this is a Google Map API dot robot. Okay, this is in this example, I'm going to show API authentication, API key authentication. And say robot, okay. So now I'm just going to create a script. So first thing is we need to add settings. Under settings, I will import or I'll refer two libraries. One is request library. And the next library is I'm going to use collections library so that I need to create some collections. Collections library, right? And then I will also create a variable section. And here I will specify the base URL. I'll say dollar symbol. And I will specify base underscore URL and my base URL is this one. So this is my base URL and the same thing is provided in the documentation also. If you just go back again, so this is the base URL I'm taking till here. Okay, and till here I'm taking as a base URL and after question mark, whatever is it, these are all filters or query parameters and I will store all the query parameters inside our dictionary variable. And then I can pass along with this request, right? So now I'm just copying my request URL till the question mark, okay? Now go to your PyCharm and now specify here. And this is I'll store only base URL one variable and request URL, I'll send another variable. So here I'll say request and also URI, uniform resource locator, identifier. So I'm just creating one more variable to send rest of the part of this particular request. So now I just create one test case. Test case is section, and I will give is Google Map. Google Map places API TC. Okay. So here, first of all, I need to create a session. So create session, and I will name it as my session. And also we need to create this session by using a base URL. So I'm just passing this base URL. And after that, I need to send a get request to this URL. And inside the get request, you need to also pass these params, request URI, and along with the parameters. So what are the parameters which we need to pass? Location, radius, types, name, and key. So let me just create params variable, which is a dictionary variable which contains a multiple values. So I will name it as params, and this is a dictionary variable. So I'm just creating create a dictionary keyword, and here I will specify the rest of the thing. So here we need to specify this location in a variable, and this is a location. Just hold on. So this is a location, and after that I will also specify the radius. After that, I will also specify the types. And after that, I'll also specify the name after tab space. And finally, we have to also specify the key here on tab space and key. So here we need to pass the key just now, whatever we have generated. So this is a key I'm passing here in the name section. All right, so now I'm taking all the query parameters into params variable, which is a dictionary variable. Now I'm going to pass these params along with the request. So now I'm going to send a get request. So I'll say get request, specify this URI, and we need to send this request by using the same session, whatever we created earlier. Now, along with this request, I need to also send all these details along with the key. So that I need to specify here. So first of all, request URI, and then also we need to send this request URI and followed by params. So all three things we have specified, and params we need to pass by adding one keyword called params equal to, right? So here we have already specified request URI, so we don't need to specify the second time. So through this my session, I am passing this base. The session is already created with the base URL. Now through this get request, I'm sending this parameter along with the filter parameters or query parameters. Now we'll get the response and store that response in a variable. In the curly braces, I will store my response. Right, so I'm storing my response in this variable. Now from this response, I'm capturing status code and the content. So here I'll say a log to console. From this response, I am capturing response dot, I'll say status underscore code. And the next thing I'm going to print is content. So from the response, I am just printing the content. So this API will support both JSON and XML. So when I say here on the request URL, when I say JSON here, it will give you response in the JSON format. Or if you pass in XML, it will give you response in the XML format, right? So this is our test case. I have stored all the query parameters, whatever I have listed here in the dictionary variable. I'm passing that dictionary variable along with the request. All right, so now let's see and execute how it is going to give you response. All right, so make sure before running, check all the parameters are right or wrong. So here, these parameters are case sensitive. So location, radius, types, and also key. The key is also case sensitive. Exact key you need to pass, right? So now let me run this. So just give robot is my keyword, and under test cases directory, my test case name is tc11 Google Maps API dot robot. Now press enter. Now it should execute now. All right, so now we can see here my test got passed, and finally you got the status is okay. That means you have successfully done the request. Now we can see the response in the JSON format. We have just printed all the content, right? So whatever these parameters are exactly matching, all the data is printed in my console window. 200 is my status code. And you can, in the result section, you can see here, And here, the main thing which we need to check is name. Name parameter also we have passed here, right? So with this name parameter harbor, so wherever the harbor is found in the name, it is printed all the data. And even rest of the records also having name contains harbor somewhere. And apart from this, we also specify the types is equal to food, right? So if you just come down and you can see the types also. Yeah, you can see the types inside this. You can also see the food here. And we can specify these types like bar, restaurant, food, point of interest and establishment. So these are the basically types which we supported by this API. So you can just pass one of the type and you can get the information. And this API key is authenticated, this API, then we got the proper response. Now we can also get the same response in the XML format. So if I just change this URL as an XML, right, save it. And now again, run this one more time. So the same test case. Now you will get the response in the XML format. So now you can see this is the same data which is there in XML format. So same response we can see in the XML format. So if we just go to top and we'll see exactly printed or not. So status is okay. Now you can see type is equal to food, I say here, and type is equal to food. And also you can see here types. We just come down a little bit here, you can see the type tags also in the XML. Yeah, harbor is a name is matching, and you can see type is a, so what is the types you specify? Types is equal to food, I specified, and types should also contains a food. So you can just copy this XML and save it in some variable and some file, then you can find out all the data properly. So let's see where exactly type is present. All right, so now you can see the type is also present in my XML file. Right, so type here, store, clothing store, establishment, and every type of data is having different type here. So I'll say food, so food related types are displayed in my response properly. Right, so this is how we can just send get request and get the response. And here the main thing is how we can authenticate this API by using API key. So that API key we need to pass as part of the parameter, and then we can capture the response. All right. So that's how we need to automate Google Maps Places API by passing the API key as an authentication. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.